I've come to know of a little known but truly great Australian by the name of Julian Edmund Tenison Woods. I'm so impressed by his tenacity, his courage and his faith, that I want to tell his story in a song. For nearly 50 years and seven, he was used as holy leaven to mission, preach, exhort and educate. A humble man but singular, he lived by this decree, always trust in the providence of God. He travelled to Australia in 1855 and soon began a priestly ministry. Appointed to Panola in the South Australian bush, where heat and drought and distance were endured. By horse he covered endless tracks, administering the rites. He'd camp under the stars or with his flock. And so began a 10-year stint among the poor bush folk. He put body, heart and soul upon the line. So sing a little Australian pioneer, whose legacy is with us to this day. In education, science and imparting faith, let us celebrate his memory. Faced caused Father Woods much pain. He'd advocate for better roads and mail. But most of all, he saw the need to educate the young and help young girls whose pride was taken away. So with Mary McKeel, he realized a dream for women of faith to educate the poor. So began the Sisters of St. Joseph at that time. They were the face of the early church in Australia. So sing of an Australian pioneer, whose legacy is with us to this day. In education, science and imparting faith, let us celebrate his memory. A servant to the people was a scientist of note. In plants and rocks, the story of the land. Was a known conservationist, a lover of the wild. It gave balance, relaxation and acclaim. Had reports and writings published in the scientific journals. Was held in high esteem among the best. But his passion for creation, it was grounded in his faith. Nature's harmony resides in God. Well known for his mission work, it took him far and wide. Tassie, New South Wales and way up north. A reputation as a speaker, he could hold a crowd in awe. His eloquence and goodness were admired. Was inclined to be eccentric and a bit of a romantic, but he managed to see the funny side of life. He loved literature and music, had a passion for the arts. It seems a fuller life you wouldn't find. He'll let me know the time we meet. I've hopefully inspired you to delve into his life, so you might understand how faith prevails. For we've each been placed upon this earth to build a living kingdom by using all the gifts that God's bestowed. And Father Woods, if nothing else, has surely done just that, a fine example of the symphony of life. So sing more than I.